$500 isn't going far with most investments, so how can you put that money to work for the highest return but without gambling it away? In this video, I'll reveal 5 ways to invest $500 for double and even triple digit returns but without that risk. I'll show you the actual returns and profits from different investments. We're talking how to invest $500 today on Let's Talk Money.
Beat debt.
Make money.
Make your money work for you.
Creating the financial future you deserve.
Let's Talk Money.
Hey Bowtie Nation, Joseph Hogue with the Let's Talk Money channel here on YouTube. I want to send a special shout out to everyone in the nation. Thank you for spending a part of your day to be here. If you're not part of that community yet, just click that little red subscribe button. It's free and you'll never miss an episode. Nation, let's face it, $500 just doesn't go very far these days. For example, investing in the stock market, the S&P 500 index, you're going to get a dividend yield of just 2.25% a year. That's it. That's about $11 a year in dividends, about enough to buy a combo meal at McDonald's. But that's about how much the average family saves each month, $500. And at that rate, it would take you 44 years to reach $1 million after adjusting for inflation. I don't know anyone that wants to wait 44 years to retire. I'd be 87 years old by the time that happens. So we're going to have to get creative here with these 5 ways to invest $500. And none of this invest in your education or just buy dividend stocks. I've got 5 ways you can invest $500 to make it go as far as possible. And I'm taking these in order of return from lowest to highest, so stick around for that last one because I'm going to show you how to turn that $500 into hundreds of thousands fast. Our first way to invest $500 is the easiest, but again, the lowest return of the 5, and that's using the sell in May phenomenon to invest. So now if you're not familiar with the sell in May idea, it's an annual trend in the stock market where stocks just tend to fall during the summer. In fact, on more than 60 years of stock market data to 2012, that May through September period is 4 of the 5 worst months to invest and the only 4 months to average negative returns. So the investing strategy here is you invest in the stock market and you can just put your money in just a broad S&P 500 market fund from November 1st through April 30th of each year. That's 6 months of every year that you're investing in the market. Now those other 6 months, starting in May, you just go to cash or maybe a very safe bond fund like the Vanguard Short-Term Bond Fund, the BSV. And I know this strategy seems ridiculously simple, but it does work. I took market data from 1950 through 2012 here to compare 3 scenarios. The section on the left is the total return just investing in those worst 6 months from May through October. The middle section is if you used this strategy, the one that we're talking about, so only invest in the market from November through April. And then the final section on the right, that's that buy and hold strategy where you just hold all your stocks all year long. And the difference in return is amazing. Investing $10,000 in 1950 and holding stocks in only that May through October period would have actually lost your money. You'd be down almost $3,700 over that 62-year period. Now look at the far right side, and that's the buy and hold strategy. And we see that the market returned an annualized 8.1% a year over those 62 years. And that's not bad. It would have turned 10 grand into about $644,000. But now look at that middle section. If you would have just invested in that November through April period and then kept your money in cash, you would have beaten the market with a return of 9.3% a year. You could have turned that $10,000 into almost $1.9 million just by using this simple strategy. And now instead of just sitting in cash from that May through October period, investing that in the bond fund like we talked about would have gotten you an extra 2% annually, so an 11.3% annual return. Even after adjusting for inflation, this simple strategy gets you to that 7-figure status in 34 years, exactly a decade faster than that blind investing strategy. Now, I would recommend using this strategy in a retirement account, so like an IRA or a Roth, just so you don't get hit every year with those taxes. It's a simple strategy and a great one to eke out a few extra percent on your returns. Now, next here is going to be investing in penny stocks, and I usually use Webull for this kind of short-term stock trading idea. I can use the stock simulator on Webull to paper trade a few penny stock ideas before I commit any of my own money. Now, the app gives you $1 million for paper portfolio to test out those strategies and follow your stocks. Now, the first thing I'll usually do when I'm looking for good penny stock investments is to run a quick search on that Webull screener. It's something just to narrow down the list. So I'll go into the app, into the screener, and you can create a new screen or just use one of the old ones. And first, I'm going to screen for companies with a market cap, and that's the company size from $200 million to $1 billion. Now, I like to keep it in this range, so I'm investing in companies with at least some financial size, but not so big that they lose that flexibility, that they're still penny stocks. Then I'll add a debt to assets screen, and we'll move this slider to about 50% debt leverage. And I like that the screener actually updates it with an estimate of the number of companies that meet your criteria as you're playing around with it. I'll also use this return on assets, or the ROA, and the return on equity screen, or the ROE, to find companies that are really performing well. You know, we can use the sliders to move these around, and really here we're just looking for at least a positive returns on assets and equity. Finally, you can also use some of these technical indicators as well to narrow your list a little bit. I like this relative strength index to find oversold stocks, and we can see here there's still 144 stocks that meet these criteria. So if we click through to any of these, we get all the technical charting and the info that we need, including news, analysis, order flow, and even distribution. So what that screener is going to do, it's going to narrow the list a little bit, but I want to use some fundamental analysis to also pick a handful of penny stocks that I think can give us some long-term as well as some short-term returns. So here I'm going to be looking at generally these three things in the financials. First, I want to find companies that have grown their sales over the last two or three consecutive years. Even if the company isn't profitable yet, it's at least getting closer with these positive sales trends. I also want to see a consistently higher operating margin. Now that operating margin, or the operating income divided by the sales on the income statement, now that trend is hugely important, especially for these small, fast-growing companies. You see, most penny stock companies, they're growing sales so fast, they're just sacrificing efficiency for growth in this stage. Now, sales are growing, but they're also spending so much on marketing and more staff that the operating margin, or that core profitability, is decreasing. But if you can find a company that's growing sales and becoming more profitable while it's doing that, you've got the potential to see earnings just explode into the future. Now, finally here, I also want to watch for runaway debt for these companies because a lot of these, they're just going to get so loose with the spending and start using all that debt instead of keeping things lean. Management rationalizes that it's okay to borrow because the company is growing so quickly, but it's just like a noose slowly tightening over the company's neck. So I'm looking for companies here that are able to produce that sales growth, do it efficiently, and stay lean without blowing out their debt-to-equity ratio. Now, penny stocks aren't for the faint of heart. This is a high-risk, high-return investing strategy, but you can average around 12% return here if you follow the steps. I know you see all kinds of penny stock strategies online here on YouTube going to promise you 20 or 30% or more, but that's usually someone trying to sell you their book or their course. Realistically, you can average 12% investing in penny stocks and small cap companies. That's enough to knock 4 more years off your journey to that $1 million portfolio. Our next way to invest $500 isn't so much a continuous strategy like these others, but I had to include it because this is free money and that makes it a huge return. I'm talking about getting the free bonus cash on investing platforms. So I've been using the Webull app for about a year now, and while I love the features for that stock market trading idea, what originally attracted me to the app was getting those 2 free shares of stock just for opening an account and making a deposit. And Webull isn't even the only place to get those free shares of stock just for signing up. I've gotten over $430 in free stock on Robinhood, including a share of Microsoft. And most of these freebie investing sites only require a deposit of $100 to qualify for those free stock offers, so you can split up your $500 and get lots of free shares. So have your spouse open an account, get an account in your kids' names. I recently did an analysis on the average value of these free share programs, found the average is around $8 on Robinhood and as high as $40 with those 2 free shares on Webull. I'll leave links in the description below the video to get your free shares. It's not something you can do every single month, but it's an instant return and easy money. The next way to invest $500 here is being a reseller or flipping, and this is really getting into those business ideas because that's where you're really going to make your money. Here I'm talking about buying either locally or online and then flipping it for a profit on eBay or Amazon or any of those online sites. We've actually talked about this strategy before on the channel in a video about huge discounts for Amazon daily deals and then selling it for a markup of 50 and 70% on eBay. Now I'd have to say I do like that online method because it cuts down a lot of the time that you'd have to spend finding those things to resell. You're not driving around to local flea markets. You know, I will say though, that kind of local to online flipping strategy can make the big money. A fellow Marine, David Perry from the Military to Millionaire channel here on YouTube, shared his reselling strategy in a Grow Your Dough challenge last year. David searched locally and flipped $300 into $1,200 in less than a month. I'll link to David's video in the description below because he really takes you through his entire strategy. Now, a few tips though, and first is just to consider specializing in a few types of products, whether it's collectibles or household items or whatever. This is going to make it easier to know how much something is worth before you buy it. Second is search for the item on eBay or use an app to see how much people are getting for it. You might also check your local Craigslist and Amazon to get those price comparisons. Finally is just have some fun with this one. Make it a family trip looking for things to buy and resell. It's a great way to spend a couple of hours with the family on a Saturday and make a couple hundred bucks while you're doing it. In that video, David shows how he made a 16,000% return on one of his flips, but realistically, you can count on at least doubling your money every month on this one. Even if you don't use that whole $500 to resell or you spend down some of your profits, you can make a lot of money. For our next way to invest $500, I'm gonna use my very own example with an online business. When I started 3 blogs in 2014, it cost me less than $400 to have someone develop the theme, get web hosting for a year, and some extras here. 6 years later, and I've made over $400,000 on my online business, and I've averaged 63% increase in monthly income every single year for the past 3. Honestly, starting your own online business is gonna be the best investment you can make, and it's gonna go a lot farther than any of these traditional investments. After that first year of blogging, I was able to cover all my expenses with income. So $500 isn't going to cover all your business expenses forever, but it will get you started and get you to that point where you're making money. And we've got quite a few videos here on the channel about starting an online business and blogging, so I'll link to one of those in the description below to get you started. Want more stock investing ideas for your money? Click on the video to the right for 5 stock picks with an average 80% return expected. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.